وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وآله الطاهرين اللهم صل على محمد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It is a great tawfiq that Allah has given us all the opportunity once again to be amongst those invited to be His guests and to be amongst those who are placed in the station of honor in this holy month, the month of Ramadan. May Allah grant us the tawfiq to be amongst those who are forgiven in this month, the month of Allah, the month of mercy, the month of forgiveness, the month of blessings, by the blessings of Allah, salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. The holy month of Ramadan grants us a chance to build a relationship with our Creator and grow closer to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, in his sermon in the last Friday of the month of Sha'ban, welcoming the month of Ramadan, he said, أيها الناس إنه قد أقبل إليكم شهر الله بالبركة والرحمة والمغفرة. O people, the month of Allah, with its blessings, with its mercy, with its forgiveness, has come upon you. شهر هو عند الله أفضل الشهور وأيامه أفضل الأيام ولياليه أفضل الليالي وَسَاعَاتُهُ أَفْضَلُ السَّاعَاتِ. It is the most preferred month of all the months of the year, in the eyes of Allah. Its days are the best of days. Its nights are the best of nights. Its hours are the best of hours. هُوَ شَهْرٌ دُعِيتُمْ فِيهِ إِلَى ضِيَافَةِ اللَّهِ وَجُعِلْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ أَهْلِ كَرَامَةِ اللَّهِ. It is a month in which you have been invited by Allah as His guests. And you have been placed amongst those who are honored by Allah. Look at the generosity of Allah in this month. The Prophet says, أَنْفَاسُكُمْ فِيهِ تَسْبِيحِ. Your breathing in it is like an act of praising and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَوْمُكُمْ فِيهِ عِبَادَةً. Your sleep in it is an act of worship. Notice how generous Allah is. Breathing and sleeping are essential to our survival. These are things that we need to do. Whether we get a reward for it or not, we're going to do it. But Allah, out of His generosity, out of His kindness, because we are His guests in this month, He has considered all of our breathing. And He has given us the reward of glorifying Him for each breath we take. Our sleep in this month, Allah has given it to us, given us the reward of worshiping Him just for sleeping in this holy month. Then the Prophet says, وَعَمَلُكُمْ فيه مقبول ودعاءكم فيه مستجاب. Your good deeds are accepted in this month. Your prayers are answered in this month. فاسألوا الله ربكم بنيات صادقة وقلوب طاهرة أن يوفقكم لصيامه وتلاوة كتابه. So ask Allah with sincere intentions, with pure hearts, that He will help you in fasting this month and in reciting His holy book. فَإِنَّ الشَّقِيِّ مَنْ حُرِمَ غُفْرَانَ اللَّهِ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ الْعَظِيمِ. Truly, the one who is ruined, the true loser, is the one who is deprived from Allah's forgiveness in this holy month. By following the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and his guidelines, we can learn how to take full advantage of these blessed days. of these blessed nights. The month of Ramadan, yes, it's 30 days. But already 4 days have passed. And we will not notice when Ramadan will end. You know, it will just pass by fast. So utilize this golden time to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and build a special relationship with Him. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 183, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. O you who believe, fasting is prescribed for you, just as it was prescribed for those before you. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you may be God-weary. So that you may be pious. So that you may fear Allah and guard yourself against evil. This is the true meaning of fasting. Yes, the apparent meaning of fasting is to sustain and endure and tolerate hunger and thirst, and to refrain from eating and drinking and all the other mufattirat, like ascribing lies to Allah, the Prophet, the holy imams, and all the other mufattirat which are listed in the book of Islamic laws. Yes, it is important and crucial to abide by these laws and refrain from all the mufattirat, so that your fasting will not be broken and it will be accepted. And these are the laws and commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is important to abide by them. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establishes a law, when He says something is wajib, something is halal, it is because there is a benefit for you. When He says this is haram, you should refrain from it, it's because it is harmful for you. The laws of Allah are made for our own benefit. For our benefit in this world and the world to come. Because He is the one who created us. And He is the one who knows how we function best. And He is the one who knows the relationship between our acts in this world and its relation or its results in Barzakh and in Akhirah. The connection of the A'mal in these three worlds. He's the one who knows it. That's why the laws of Allah are for our benefit, whether in this world or in the next or in both. But that is the apparent meaning of fasting. There is a deeper meaning behind it. There is a deeper meaning of fasting, of siyam. One should work both on the physical and spiritual realm. Our sixth Imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, when you fast, your ears, your eyes, your hair, your skin, and all your limbs must be fasting. All of your body must be fasting. What do you mean, Ya Ja'far al-Sadiq? What does it mean that my eyes and ears and hair and skin and my body part must be fasting? When it comes to fasting the month of Ramadan, like any other ritual, we must utilize the guidelines provided by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger of Allah, he himself explained the deeper meaning behind fasting. He said, fasting is not only abstaining from food and drink alone. When you fast, protect your tongue from lying, fasting of the mouth. When you fast, lower your gaze from what Allah has forbidden you to see, fasting of the eyes. Do not fight with one another. Do not be jealous of one another. Do not backbite one another. Do not abuse one another. Do not be unjust to one another. refrain from false accusation, refrain from lying, refrain from suspicion, from backbiting, from slandering, and wait for your days. Wait for what Allah has promised to those who have prepared to meet Him. You must have tranquility. You must have humility. You must have servility and submissiveness of a slave who fears his master. And be fearful of Allah's chastisement, as well as be hopeful of receiving His forgiveness. This is the deeper meaning of fasting. These are the guidelines that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has put for us. It is narrated in Bihar al-Anwar that our sixth Imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, he said that my father said that once the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, for his love recite aloud salawat. He said once Rasulullah was walking and he noticed a woman who was fasting insulting another woman. So Rasulullah immediately went and offered her food and asked her to eat. The woman was surprised. She said, Ya Rasulullah, I cannot eat. I'm fasting. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was surprised. He said, how are you fasting and you have just insulted this woman? Fasting is not abstaining from food and drink. Rather, Allah made this hijab, made this a veil from other immoral acts and words. Allah made this fasting a veil from all the other immoral acts and words, which breaks the fast. Then he said, مَا أَقَلَّ الصُّوَامِ وَمَا أَكْثَرَ الْجُوَامِ. How few are those who are fasting, and how many are those who are hungry? Rasulullah is pointing towards the deeper meaning of fasting.